Delegates across the province joined the proceedings from their homes. Others connected virtually at hybrid venues with strict compliance to COVID-19 protocols. About 70% of the eligible voters cast their votes virtually. Basson, Tsonakile and Snyders were joined by Don Van Zyl, Nkateko Mabunda and Irma Rosu as DPG provincial chairpersons. Their focus, the upcoming local elections.
Yes, I think the first thing that the DA needs to do in Northwest, we need to reconnect with our voters. We will also concentrate on municipalities and also committees within the municipalities that's been taken up in our constitution.
The outgoing provincial leader dismissed allegations that he was instructed not to contest the provincial leadership again.
I have made this decision not to stand because I believe in new blood, I believe in fresh blood, I believe in young leadership as well. So this narrative of that black leaders are being pushed up, pushed out of this party, it's a blatant lie. I have not been pushed out. I don't want to become a Robert Mugabe in the organization.
Meanwhile, a political analyst says the newly elected DA provincial leadership has a lot of work to do.
So there will be huge pressure on the leadership of the Democratic Alliance in the province to take them forward. I think it is back to basics, as Leon Basson mentioned, the ABC of politics. There's a need to strategize, there's a need to reposition. Because according to my political assessment, we are into a big reconfiguration.
The party plans to concentrate on grassroots politics in preparation of the upcoming local government election after losing two significant wards in the last week's by-elections. Deboho Pakedi, SABC News, Potchefstroom.